Removing a colour cast in a picture. It's got to be my favourite method. It's one that I did sort of quite a while ago. That's the original I did on my blog, on my, what's it called, Quicktip landscape. And I thought I'd just show you again, because that was the before image. This is the after image. It was one I used from Jeff, a member of the members area. If we just come and take a look at this picture here. Again, I have tried all different types of removing the colour cast. And I must be honest, I keep coming back to this one. It is so quick. It is so simple. It is unbelievable. And you got flexibility as well. Let me show you. Command J or Control J will duplicate the background layer. Next, we're going to go to Image, Adjustment, dropping down, then the magic takes place in Match Color. With Match Color, taking a look at the dialog box here, I'm just going to move it to the side to give ourselves just a little bit more room. We've got the Image Options, dropping down to Neutralize. This is where it takes place. Clicking on Neutralize, through it comes. Right, working our way up, you've got the Fade slider, and as we move this across, you'll notice the way we can sort of bring back the image. You can take it all the way to 100. That's going to give it as it was with the color cast. You may prefer to dial it back the other way. Something like this area here looks pretty good. Moving our way up the sliders, we've got color intensity. What does this do? If you drop it back in this direction, gives us a little bit of a clue. It removes the saturation from the already saturated colors, very much like the vibrant slider. So we can move that up to that area there. Looks pretty good. You can see it there in particular in the life belt. And again in the red hull in the background. You can see the way we can just sort of drop it from that to that. Looking good so far, he says, moving it in a little bit more. The luminance, what does this do? Well, if we take it back this way, you can see it takes the brightness out of the image, the luminance out of the image, moving it in the other way. That looks pretty good. Something like that. Just fading that in. Just ticking the preview box. That's what we started off with. That's what we got so far. Click OK to that. How quick and easy is that? One thing I would recommend is with the layer, just click on it and put in... Oh, no, it wasn't that, was it? I was going to put in there match colour. That's what I wanted to put in. Right, so you know exactly what you've done on that particular layer. Next thing, let's take a look at the image. Now, I haven't adjusted the levels with this at all, and the one thing that I would say is when you've got sort of a picture like this, if you come in and you adjust the image, if you go to the adjustment layer and you go to layers, you're adjusting it globally for the entire picture. One thing you do find with water is the tonal range of water and the tonal range of the sky is going to be completely different from the rest of the picture. So, if you break it down into its individual components, it doesn't matter if it's a puddle, it doesn't matter if it's an ocean. Where you've got water, try this, it really does work a treat. First things first, we need to select the water. I'm going to come up, going to pick up the quick selection tool, going to quickly come around this area like that, something in and just bringing it through, perhaps just a little bit on the top here as well, so that doesn't feel left out. You see it's just come over the edge. Just going to press the Alt or the Option key and just chance my luck bringing that back. That'll do nicely. Not going to fuss around too much. I know you'll do a much better job anyway. But once we've done that, drop down to the adjustment layers. Now go to Levels, clicking on this. That brings up the adjustment layer. And if we just take a look, you'll notice the way it's taken the mask through there as well. So that's what we're working with. So coming back to the adjustment layers, you'll notice there's a bit of a gap as well. There's no pixels in this area here, so if we just click down, we move it in. Press and hold down the Alt or the Option key, holding that down as we move it across. It's the solid whites is what we want to avoid. It's what we don't want to use. Solid whites is where it's going to be clipped, so we're going to move it back into that sort of area there. Taking a look, looks pretty good. Doing exactly the same, holding down the Alt or the Option key, moving it across. Try not to forget your words. This time it's blacks that we want to sort of, avoid. That was the word I was trying to think of. It's the blacks. If we got the solid blacks, that's where it's going to be clipped. So we can afford to move this back into that sort of area. There should be pretty good. Let's take a look. Perhaps just in a wee bit more. Like that. Like that. Coming through, just switching this on and off. And if we just making a slight adjustment with the center slider. Great stuff. Right, coming through. What we can now do, and one thing I didn't do when I made the selection, you may have noticed quite a hard edge there, is make sure you're working on the mask. This would be in sort of CS4 and any previous versions of Photoshop to CS4. Now go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. In CS5 we can click on the mask, we can come to Feather. Now with the amount in the Gaussian Blur and the Feather, just take this up to something between 3 and 6 should do the job nicely. It's just going to sort of feather that edge, just soften that edge off nicely for us. Right, coming back to the Layers panel. Press and hold down Control or Command. Click down. You've made a selection of that mask. If we go to Select, we can go to Inverse. We've now selected the top part of the image because now we've got this nice and bright. Let's see what we can do with the top part here. Dropping down, once again, we're going to go to Levels. Coming through on this, you'll notice the way this is tailing off as well in the highlights. Bringing it through like this and just taking a look. Don't want to go too mad. Again, we don't want to, you know, we want to avoid the sort of the white areas there, which is where it would be clipped. So just bringing that back a touch or two. You can see the way that's just feathered off there nicely as well. Coming through onto the center slider here, the gamma slider. Just making a little bit of a change with that. Job done. Taking a look. There's the before. There's the after. If we take a look at the entire picture, that's our before. That's our after, the removal of the color cast. Don't forget we can come in, we can change the tonal range of the water there and the sort of area above. Because we've feathered it, we've knitted the two together, you're not going to get any traces coming through there. Great stuff. So there it is. Go on, give it a try. It is just a quick and simple way of removing a color cast. Like I've tried all the other methods and this is the fastest, this is the best one I've come across. And if you've got a question, if you've got a comment, please don't hesitate to get in touch. And until the next time, it's happy imaging and take care.